universe now is the First Order. If everyone in the galaxy, in the universe, is siding with the First Order and saying, yes, we're going to play by their rules, then doesn't the Resistance trying to force their way become like what the terrorists are doing nowadays, if everyone's be so PC and touchy and pricky about shit like that? Small group of people. So, I mean, it sets it up in a wrong way. Basically, I got the feeling when I was watching this that everything JJ seemed to be setting up in The Force Awakens was soundly ignored and pissed on by Rian Johnson at every chance. Like, every turn, if he could piss on it, he would. And ultimately, it left it... This movie is so isolated, is so segmented as its own little thing, that I'm pretty sure when number 9 comes out, you'll be able to watch 7 and 9 and not even really care that there was an 8. Other than you need 8 to get to 9 when you're counting. But when you're watching the movies, you won't need it. It'd be like, skip 8, not worth it. I think in this case, it'd be 7 and 9. Don't fuck with 8. Just forget 8. Unless the powers that be decide to let JJ go and make a new number 8. Like, don't remake The Last Jedi. Make a new number 8 that will work with whatever his number 9 is. I don't think that's going to happen. I also didn't think I'd ever see a Star Wars movie that I hated. So, what the fuck do I know, right? Here's my takeaway from the whole fiasco. This movie felt very much like somebody that is not really into the genre, but they want to make a fan film because it's popular. Like somebody that's not into science fiction or fantasy or any of that, but they know that Star Wars fan films will get noticed. And they're like, I'm going to make one. And they just go like, okay, they're in space, they got cool looking ships, they got the big furry thing, what's he? I don't know. But the big furry thing, some droid, shiny droid things, okay, cool. Oh, Jedi dude, I don't even care what they do, let's just, yeah. And then you try and you go and you make a fan film of something that you have no fucking clue on. It'd be like me making a fan film of Doctor Who. I know enough to say that I know who Doctor Who is. I recognize the concept and some things like the TARDIS and the sonic screwdriver. But for me to make a fan film, I would have to watch all of the movies. I would have to talk to at least a couple of people that are lifelong fans and have followed it since day one or since whenever, you know, is a recognized point to jump on. Get with them and hash out some stuff like, okay, I'd like to do this, this, and this. Does that fit? Yes, no, yes, no. And then go from there. Rian Johnson just made his own Star Wars fan film the way he wanted to. And it makes no sense when you take it as part of the whole. It's number 8 out of a 9 movie story. Can't do that. It's got to at least nod to those that came before and maintain that feeling. And it didn't. My advice, if you haven't seen it, rent it for free. Watch it once. Once is all you're going to need. If you're not curious, don't see it. It's not great. It's not a good movie. Hey, that's just my opinion, and opinions are like assholes. Everybody's got one, and how many people actually want to hear from it? That's my thoughts on it. I just hope to God that number 9's good. Oh, fuck me.